So I am the chairman of the ICME. That is not a rap singer. ICME stands for Interim Committee on Ministerial Education. We were formed as a committee at the 33rd General Assembly, and this past year we have focused on three areas of study. The first area is developing courses that would meet the new academic standards that you approved as an assembly last year. Secondly, defining and beta testing the Mentored Apprenticeship Program, which you will be hearing about in just a moment. And third, we are looking at the call of commissioned pastor and trying to develop that a little more effectively and articulately to present to you next summer. So what I would like to do at this time, that is, we don't have any recommendations from the committee, but I'd like to invite the stated clerk appointed director of the Mentored Apprenticeship Program, Teaching Elder Kent Mathews, to come up here and join me, and he's going to share with you about the MAP program. The airlines lost Kent's suitcase. So I can confidently tell you that Kent is probably the only individual in this sanctuary who is here without baggage.
I wish that were true. Are you ready with my slide? So, one of the strategic initiatives that we as a denomination embraced several years ago is effective biblical teaching. ICME is trying to promote that goal and that initiative. One of the ways we're doing it is through the MAP program, which stands for Mentored Apprenticeship Program. So the MAP program is redundant. It's the Mentored Apprenticeship Program, but I'm going to refer to it as the MAP program. Dean was talking this morning about the next generation, which is this generation, and one of our responsibilities to the next generation is to properly disciple them, since they are the disciplers of the next generation of disciplers. Now, everybody who's been to seminary will say that my seminary education did not fully or properly perhaps prepare me for ministry. We're trying to take responsibly the need to better prepare people for ministry. Most of the innovation that has occurred in the last 20 years in seminary education has been format. Can we do it online? Can I do it in my home or through my computer? Or can I reduce the number of hours that I have to take? But two of the most important things that need to happen are how do we provide better vehicles of training and how can we reduce cost? This is what we're trying to take seriously through the MAP program. Now, if you were here last year or you read this, you were aware that revisions in ministerial education no longer just say an MDiv with languages. It now specifies hours that students have to take. If you take out the blocks of Bible and theology and history, which total 42 hours, then there are 8 individual courses that are still required to be taken. And this is what they are, organized according to acronyms that I can remember, DELP and MAPE. So here's how this works if you come before a ministerial committee. Do you have an MDiv? Yes, check. Do you have the major blocks of hours? 12 Old Testament hours, 12 New Testament hours, 9 systematic theology hours, and 9 church history hours. Now, we test for other things through ordination exams, through English Bible competency, language competency through a new exegesis exam, Reformed theology, sacraments, and then polity through examination. But that leaves the 8 other 3-hour courses which ministerial committees are supposed to check off on degrees now. You would probably agree that these are valid and important courses for future pastors to take. But here's the problem. The problem is that all 8 of these courses are ministry-related and skill-based, but only preaching is currently uniformly taught in a practical way. Only preaching is required that you practice this while you're studying it. But shouldn't a pastor be required to practice evangelism or discipleship or leadership or pastoral care and counseling? Aren't these equally important skills to develop in the training process? Do we want all pastors to just have a piece of paper that they've read books and written papers and they don't show up with any practical experience with this? We think that they should have to practice these things. This is the reason the Mentored Apprenticeship Program was developed. So 8 courses are currently in development that the EPC has envisioned and is designing in a pilot program that's being administered by Gordon Conwell Theological Seminary in Charlotte. 5 courses will be available this fall. We piloted the first one this winter. We're doing 2 of them currently this summer, and the final 3 will be developed in 2018. All of these are at half the cost of a normal seminary course. So if the MAP courses are online courses, so any student in any seminary anywhere in the country can add these to their current curriculum if they want to get more practical courses at half the cost. So they will do the typical coursework, which is lectures, papers, readings, and then they will do a in-the-field project that's supervised by a student-chosen mentor. 50% of the responsibility of the class would be the traditional coursework, and then the other 50% would be the project and the mentoring. So the project, for example, will involve doing something in the field that you're studying. So for example, is somebody equipped to lead or teach evangelism as a pastor if all they've done is read a book on it? Wouldn't you want your pastor to have actually had to do some evangelism while they were studying it? We think they should. Shouldn't your pastor have done leadership or discipleship rather than just showing up at the door and saying, got my degree and I'm going to learn at your expense, or I'm going to learn on the job? There's any number of projects that would be appropriate for any class. I want you to read just one of them. This is a project from the ethics course this winter. You read it, I don't need to read it to you. Really? Okay. So, to explore the ethical implications related to sending missionaries overseas and the conduct of missionaries while abroad. To address questions regarding their permission to be abroad, including visas and platform while in country. To address some of the murkier aspects of mission work, including but not limited to, when and if it's ever permissible to pay a bribe or extortion fee, what behavior standards missionaries ought to live by when abroad, and how missionaries should report back to their sending churches or agencies. The goal of this project is to strengthen the relationship, transparency, and trust between missionaries and their sending churches and agencies. When this student is done, after this this project has been vetted in the paper, it could be made available to any other churches that are trying to answer the same question. Wonderful projects were developed in this first pilot ethics course. So a pastor mentor, every student then identifies a pastor or other ministry leader who's involved in the leadership of a church or some other ministry and recruits them to be their mentor during the taking of the course. And the two meet at agreed upon times regularly, hopefully every week, and they talk about what the student is learning in the course. So what happens is the student's able to process out loud what they're studying academically. You don't learn nearly as much if all you do is read a book and keep it internally. You learn a whole lot more when you talk about it with somebody else. You also talk about your project and what you're learning through the project, and the student is able to learn more about himself and about ministry as a result of doing this as well. Now, the interim committee was challenged with 3 core values that they were to implement. One is necessary academic education, which we've tried to take responsibility for. The second is appropriate character development, and the third is diverse practical experience. We've learned a 4th value, which we are implementing in the MAP program, and that is that both number 2 and number 3, character development and practical experience, are best acquired in a mentoring experience, where an older, seasoned pastor takes under their wing somebody who's studying to be a pastor, shares their wisdom and experience with them, cares for them, loves for them, prays for them, and guides them into ministry. Now, here is the schedule for classes. As I mentioned, the ethics class was already pioneered this spring or winter. We're doing the leadership and the discipleship classes this summer, this fall, so that 5 courses will be available to anybody that wants to take this, evangelism and ministry as mission. Dr. Mike Moses, who is an adjunct professor at Gordon Conwell, is actually developing and will be presenting and be the teacher for the ministry as mission course, which we're really excited about, and then you can see what the others are. So let me share with you very quickly. Who benefits from this program? Everybody benefits from this program. Number one, current APC seminary students benefit from this program. If the average cost of an average seminary course is $500 per hour, for a three-hour course, that's an average of $1,500 per course. All of these courses are available at half price for $750. So if you take all eight courses, you save $6,000 off of your seminary education. And if you choose to take the field education credits associated with each of these, you can save another $1,500. So you can save $7,500 off your education by taking a course from a ATS-accredited seminary in a format that's actually a better way for you to take the course. Do you think students would be interested in that? You bet they would be interested in that. Number two, who benefits from this is future EPC pastors. So they're not just reading about things in a book and just writing papers about it. They're being mentored by somebody who cares about them, and they're actually implementing what they're learning while they're learning it. Number three are EPC churches that have pastors that don't just have a degree with having read a bunch of books, but have actually done these eight things in the field while they studied them. And then fourth is the entire EPC denomination, which benefits from this. We will increasingly become a denomination whose ethos and passion is discipling the next generation of pastors. How do we currently do it? We send them off to seminary, say, God bless you as you go get your degree, and then when you get your degree, we will trust that you can come back and be an effective pastor. This system allows current pastors to take increased responsibility for discipling the next generation of disciplers, to pour into them what somebody poured into us by trial and error in the field. And then fifth, EPC pastor mentors benefit from this. If you talk to the ones who have done this as our beta test, they will tell you that being able to talk about subjects that they maybe studied 20, 30 years ago, but they maybe haven't thought about all of them in 20 or 30 years, but they get a chance to reflect on this, process it, and interact with an intelligent, articulate student about this. It's great for the pastor to be able to do this again. It's not just something that's a book on the shelf. Now, we've also designed a certificate program. So if you have anybody else in your church, a youth leader, a children's ministry director, or anybody else, whether they have a bachelor's degree or not, they can take any of these courses themselves. And if they take at least six of the eight courses, they can earn a certificate of completion of the MAP program from Gordon Conwell and from the EPC. It's a wonderful way of training your staff for a minimal cost that provides them with academic training as well as other mentored training. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on this right now, but it's a Doctor of Ministry program that's being developed to go along with this so that starting in February, if anybody who wants to see themselves as a mentor or a discipler of future pastors, at the same time that they themselves are working on their own skills and abilities, can enter into this program with other EPC pastors doing it, and they can become a better communicator, a better leader, and a better pastor of care and visitation, but at the same time learn how to better disciple the next generation of pastors in this as well. And then finally, anybody who's a ministerial committee person knows that we all have people who already have their MDiv, but aren't ordained, and they need to fulfill these requirements. So Gordon Conwell has graciously made all of these courses available at a ridiculously low price, so that if the ministerial committee wants this candidate for ordination to finish these requirements in this way, they can take it through Gordon Conwell. I think that's it. I know this is really quick. There is a copy of this in your notebook. There's also online, there's a brochure that has more information on it that you can get under the miscellaneous resources section on the EPC website for GA. And I hope what you will do is that you will talk about this within your church, within your presbytery, so that this starts to grow in terms of interest and excitement, because it is a wonderful product, if product is the right word, to offer future pastors to help them reduce the cost of education and to study ministry classes the way they should have always been taught in the first place. Thank you.